Hi and welcome to our channel, the best place to learn how to use and master Canva. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna give you 5 super cool and very trendy ideas to create your own Instagram covers for free in Canva. And I will show you every step you need to follow to create and upload your Instagram highlight covers. If you don't know what those are, the highlight covers are these little circular shapes or bubbles right below your Instagram bio. By creating your own covers and giving them an aesthetic and harmonious look, it is going to make your Instagram account look more attractive, cohesive, and organized. Just to remind you, all the steps in this tutorial are free, so you can follow it if you have a Canva free account or a Canva Pro account. So, are you guys ready for this tutorial? Let's go to my computer. The first idea for your highlight covers are colors. So this one is the easiest highlight cover, I would say. So what we are going to do is to create an empty document and we're going to search for Instagram story highlight cover. Just going to go to this search result. We are going to find a bunch of different templates for these specific covers. So I'm going to select the blank Instagram story highlight cover because we're going to create our own. Even though you can do it, you can go ahead, you can click on any of these templates and select all the different highlight covers that you would like to use and tweak them as you like. But in this tutorial, we are going to do everything by ourselves. So to create these color covers, we are just going to select the background of this empty Canva, and on the toolbar, we are going to select the color option. So let's click on it, and here you will have access to your color palettes. In case that you are using Canva Pro, you will see your color palettes here. If not, you will have Canva's default colors, but here on the top where you see new color, you can select this option and try to find the color that you prefer or insert your hex code right here. Another way to find different colors is by typing on this search box. So for example, you have no idea what kind of blue you want to use, but you know you want to use a blue color. So let's type blue, and here we already have a bunch of different color palettes. So what we are going to do is to, let's select the green one. We are going to add another page, select the other color, and so on until we have the amount of highlight covers that we need to use or we want to upload to our Instagram. So I'm just going to click on the grid view. You see on the bottom right hand side, we have this option. And like this, we can view the different colors that we're going to be using on our covers. Another way I want to also give you a bonus here is to use, let's go back to our normal view. And the option that I want to tell you is styles. So on the left hand side, you see there is an option called styles. So let's click on it. And again, I have a Canva Pro account, so I can access my brand kit settings from here directly. So I have access to my fonts, my colors. But if you don't have a Canva Pro account, you can go below where it says trending, or you can go to the next tab and we can go to colors. So here again, I have my brand kit, but if you have a Canva free account, you can select any of these other color palettes. And let's say that I want to select this one, Punks Not Dead. This is muy difícil. And let's say that I want to select this one, Candyland. So I'm just going to select the background of this page and click on Candyland. Going to the second page and I'm going to click again on Candyland one and two times. And like that, Canva is going to be giving different colors every time. So the third page, one, two times, and I have a different color. And the same process for the last page, one, two, and I have a different color. So I'm just going back to my grid view and I have here four different colors from a color palette that Canva gave me automatically. So yeah, I was able to create this color palette with the resources that are available for free in Canva. The second idea for your Instagram highlight covers are icons or illustrations. And I'm super happy about this one because Canva has so many icons and illustrations inside their library. So for this one, we are going to the left menu. You see there is the elements category. So we are just going to open this window, and here we can do two things. The first one is to use the search box right here. So let's say that my account is all about content creation. So I may have one cover related to filming. So why not adding maybe a camera icon? So let's try to find a camera. And I have here a couple of icons, some illustrations, but let's say that we want to add only icons. So let's use this one. We are going to add another page. And let's say that for the next one, I want to talk about copywriting. So let's try to find a pencil icon. And we can use this one, and we can add a circle behind so it looks more similar to this one. And you can like keep going and try to find different icons for the different categories that you're going to be adding on your highlight covers. Another thing that I would like to mention here is that on the search box you will have this little settings icon, so you will like to click on it if you want to filter all of these results by color or elements that are static or animated elements that will be the stickers. And then we have availability, free or pro. So if you have a Canva free account, just select the free one and apply filters, and then you will be sure that all the results that you're going to see are completely free. So these are the icon ideas, and then the illustrations is very similar to what I just showed you. You are going to type here whatever you want, but instead of selecting an element that looks like an icon, you can select these kind of elements that look more like illustrations. And then I want to go back, so I'm going to close here the search results, and when you scroll down inside this little window, you will see a bunch of different selection of illustrations that are very trendy, and maybe you would like to use these ones for your Instagram covers. So let's select, for example, the organic rainbow. So let's click on see all, and then here we have a bunch of different rainbows, but all have the same aesthetic and they look harmonious when you see them all together. It's good that you select the icons or illustrations that have the same style for your account to look organized. So let's click on any of these rainbows. So what I want to do is a little trick that you should follow if you want your illustrations to look complete when you are going to upload them to Instagram. So I'm just going to select this one, and let's go for this one here and this one. Now I'm going back, I'm going to close these search results, and let's go back to the elements category, and then I'm going to select the circular shape, and then I'm just going to stretch the circle by pressing Alt. So I'm pressing Alt or Option in Mac, and then stretching my circle until it touches the edge of the page. Now what I want to do is position backward, and then I can make my rainbow bigger. And why did I add the circle? Because this is going to show me where Instagram is going to cut my image. So if I make my rainbow too big like this, I'm going to take it back, this part of the rainbow is going to be automatically cropped and it won't look as nice as we were expecting. So this is very important and I recommend you guys to do it. So let's make sure that your rainbow or your element is inside the circular shape. And then when you are happy with the size of the element, just remove the circle. In the next video that I'm going to upload, I will give you 10 keywords for you to find a bunch of cool hidden elements in Canva. So if you are interested in finding more unique and maybe some elements that not everyone is using at the moment, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss that video. And then I also love to recommend you guys 2 videos every tutorial, and today I want to recommend you the previous tutorial that I uploaded to the channel. In that tutorial I give you 5 Instagram post ideas, so if you are interested in Instagram and how to get more engagement and how to create trendy content, that video is going to be super useful. And then I'm also going to recommend up here another tutorial that you can watch after finishing this one on how to create thumbnails for YouTube. I think you're going to really like those tutorials, and let's go back to the 3rd idea that I have for you guys today. The 3rd idea that I have for you guys today for your Instagram highlight covers is adding text to your covers. And I would like to show you one way in which you can find font combinations automatically already created in Canva, and also some text effects that may add a little touch, like a nice touch. Perdí mi hilo. Okay. And then I'm also going to show you a different way in which you can find texts that have already some text effects on it. And I guess this is going to add a unique touch to your Instagram highlight covers. So the first one is inside the styles option. So we're going to click on it, we're going to open this window, and then on top we see 3 different tabs. So we have all, we have colors, and then we have fonts. So let's click on fonts. I have my brand kit fonts, so you will see it here because I have a Canva Pro account. But if you have a Canva free account, you should see something like this. So let's go for, let's say, Anton and Prompt Medium. With just one click, I will add these 2 fonts to my empty Canva. So let's say that I want to try a different one. Let's click on the next one, Cormorant Garmont. And like this, we will be testing different kind of fonts. And something cool about this styles category is that if you go to all, you already have a combination of fonts and color palettes. So let's say that I liked the Cormorant Garmont. I don't know how you pronounce that, but you get it. Let's click on it. And if you click another time, so I clicked just once and I have this combination right here. If I click 2 times, I have another different combination. So if I add another page, I will have the same one. If I click another time, I will have this different color. And like this, I can create so many different versions of the same cover, and with just a couple of clicks, Canva does it automatically for us. And if you want to change the text inside the text box, just double click and then you will be able to change the color on your text box. And then the second option that I wanted to show you for the text styles are, let me just add a new page. You are going to the text category. So on this text category, we will see a bunch of different texts that already have effects on them. So some of them have the Pro label, so if you have a Canva Pro account, you can use them without any issues. But if you go below, some of them will be free, like for example the Sparkle one, Sweet, Hustle, like all of these are free. Let me click on the Glow. This one has a more interesting effect, and we can change the background for a black so we can see it really, really glowing. And then for the covers that are going to be using text, I recommend using bold fonts and using few letter words, because remember that your highlights are going to be this small, so you need to make sure that people are able to read your covers. If not, then it doesn't really make sense to add text to your highlight covers. The 4th idea that I have for you guys today are textures. So this is pretty simple. We are going to go to the photos category, Let's click on it. And here we have a bunch of different photos available from the Canva library. We can filter here by color, by orientation, availability, cutout. So let's go for free. I know that many of you guys don't have Canva Pro yet. So let's do a simple search. Let's say that I want to have some nature vibes in my Instagram highlight covers. So let's just type nature texture and let's go. So here we will find a bunch of really nice photos, and I just want to remind you that these are free photos. So let's apply filters, and we just are going to drag our photos to our empty background. So let's just select a couple of them and maybe add one more, like this one and this mask, and let's check them out. So we're going to have something like this. Also, let's go back to photos and to this filter option, and let's try to find green images. So let's go for this one. If you want to have only green textures, let's filter by green, and let's see, we will have a bunch of just green options. So we have a theme right here, so I guess maybe this one. Let's go and see. So yeah, we have a bunch of different textures. They look similar, but they are still different. So this is another idea. And this takes us to our fifth idea. This is the last idea of the day. And these are photos. So you can also add photos to your Instagram highlight covers. Just try to select high quality or really good looking photos to your highlights so they look nice. And let's say that we want to find some beach photos. Okay, so let's see, I have a bunch of pro options. So let's go to our filter and select free, and let's just drag our photos to our background. Let's keep adding pages, and let's see, something that looks very aesthetic and that can bring us these beach vibes. I think this can bring a really, really cool vibe to our account. And lastly, just following this idea of photos, you can also upload your own photos to Canva. So for this, you are going to open the uploads category, and you can upload your own media right here. Just click on this button. This will give you access to the media on your computer, and you will be able to upload your own images. So let's say that I want to upload on my highlight covers my own pictures. So I just drag them here, and I have my own photos in my designs or my highlight cover. So it is this simple. And now we have reached the last part of the tutorial, in which I show you how to actually download these Instagram highlight covers and how to upload them to your Instagram account. Okay, now that we have created and we have all our highlight covers done, to upload them I need the images on my phone. So for me, the easiest way is to actually access this document from my Canva app. So I opened my Canva app, I accessed the document that I created from my desktop, and now that I have all my rainbows ready here, I'm just going to tap on the top navigation bar, this arrow pointing downwards. So what this is doing is that it is automatically downloading all the images to my camera roll. So now I'm going back to this Instagram account that I have for doing all these tests. As you can see, I have this puzzle theme on this feed, and I have a tutorial for this one. If you want to watch it, you can go and check it out on our channel. But let's go for the highlights. So on this account, we don't have any highlights. So now, how do we create our highlight covers? We are going to create an Instagram story. So let's just tap our profile image, and we are going to upload a story. So I'm just going to upload one of our highlight covers, and let's click on your story. You see down below, let's tap on it. And now that we have one story uploaded to our account, let's click again on our profile image and we will access to our Instagram story. So now that we have this, if you already have your stories uploaded, you don't have to do this step, just go to your stories and you see below we have this option that is called highlight. So let's tap on it and click on add. So view on profile. And now we have our first highlight. If you want to edit it and you want to change it, just press on the highlight and you will see the second option. It says edit highlight. So like this, you can edit the cover and on the left side, you see this icon. Just select the icon. And from here, you can actually change your cover. Done. And if you want, you can also change the text here. You can also add an emoji if you want. And here you have your highlight. So now if you want to add more highlights, it's even easier. You see on the right hand side next to our highlight, we have this plus icon and it says new. So click on it. We are going to select any of our stories that are available at the moment. Next, edit cover. And then we're going to select another cover and add our highlight. And like this, we are going to create our highlights and have them ready on our account. And I would like to ask you something. Will you be interested in learning how to create websites in Canva? Let me know in the comments. I would like to see if you are actually interested. And before ending this month, we have one more video coming up because this month we reached 50,000 followers. And I felt inspired to share more with you. So if you are interested in finding new and unique hidden elements in Canva, make sure to subscribe right now. Subscribing is a good way to support our channel. And if you are already subscribed, share our tutorials with your friends. This will help us a lot. And on the other hand, if you want to keep learning about Canva, I'm going to leave you guys some tutorials here that I think you may be interested in. And I'm also going to leave a link here in case that you want to check out my Canva profile. I have a bunch of new Canva templates that are available for Canva Pro users. So I guess this is it for now. I wish you a nice day and see you in the next tutorial. Bye!